Hello friends, my name is Sava Terentyev. I talk about music, publishing music, about life, and today about death also. So on Friday, May 11th, in the evening, I read the news of passing away of Misha Alperin, which was a sad thing to discover because he was an extraordinary musician with the richest mind and a perfect mastering of piano and other instruments, and also versatile playing in multiple of musical genres. I first discovered him in 2007 when I heard his record with Arkady Shelklopper called Wave of Sorrow. It's a very powerful and majestic record, although it stays beautiful and very delicate as well. And I would say it's a very masculine piece of art, full of small, fine details arranged in a very vast and rich space. The space was probably provided by Manfred Eicher, who was the record producer, the head of ECM Records, who is well known for his vision of his hearing of space in the music he deals with. It's a very interesting record, and the music on it is very much folk-oriented. It's piano mostly. Misha Alperin plays the piano and melodica and also sings. And Arkady Shelklopper plays French horn and flugelhorn. It's very much folk based. One track out of 10 is a little bit in a blues manner, although very, very much reworked in Misha Alperin's unique style. Misha was born in Ukraine in 1956 and started studying music still as a child, because his mother was a music teacher, and then he went to a children's music school, and then he continued at a musical college. And then around 1980 he started trying jazz music, and this is what he writes about it. Up to around 1980, I mostly played classical stuff, at least officially. Then, of course, I had to learn everything from Art Tatum to Herbie Hancock. Luckily, I did that fast enough to forget it rather soon. And I think it's true, you know, although I haven't heard any records of his from the 80s, with the exception of the aforementioned Wave of Sorrow, but that was already recorded in 89, there are very, very few jazz elements there, but in general it sounds like very good contemporary music with strongest influences of different European folk music. And I think that in fact Misha Alperin was the one who introduced me into this kind of contemporary music, which has both jazz influences and European classical influences and folk music influences at the same time. And I think the reason why later on I became so much interested in Tigran Amasyan and eventually started working with him was because I was once deeply touched by the music of Misha Alperin. And in fact he was in the short list of those artists whom I very much wanted to be signed one day with a terentyev music publishing company. But yeah, as the Germans and Russians say, the train has gone. Yeah. Too late now. There are a couple of quotes from Misha Alperin, which are included in the booklet of the Wave of Sorrow album, which I wanted to read, and I think they illustrate him quite well. He says, "All folk music belongs to the same family, and I wish to break down barriers and borders, not only geographically, but also historically, the borders between epochs. I don't mean aping or reproducing folk music in its original form." And another quote is the following. "The Jewish element? Oh yes, I suppose it's there. I think maybe all suppressed peoples on this earth of ours have tried to express their sorrows in a way that does not necessarily convey sorrow. You know, the need to laugh between the tears. The Jewish way has always been tragicomical. Yes, maybe you can hear it in the music." So friends, I encourage you to listen to music of Mikhail Alperin, to discover a rich world of a man who lived a rich and a wondrous life. I wish you all good and see you next time.